द वन थिंग आई एम रियली ग्लैड अबाउट इज दैट आपका पीपीटी तभी बनना चालू हुआ जब हमारा मल्टीप्लेयर फेज चालू था, दैट इज ड्यूरिंग द एक्चुअल इवेंट. सो या आई एम वेरी प्राउड ऑफ यू फॉर दैट.
थैंक्स थैंक्स टू यू, थैंक्स टू बीआरएम एंड थैंक्स टू यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मुंबई. This is the best thing that ever taught me in life. Awesome. So I will start sharing. The intent when I started creating these slides was not to come from a space of gyan ki main bahut kuch bolunga, because bol to main kafi kuch sakta hu, but I don't know how much of it will make sense. So if at any point if you want to stop, if you think that PPTs are not making sense or want to ask questions, feel free to either enter them in the chat or raise your hand or just start speaking. Not really a problem. The idea about today's sharing is largely around some of the work that I am trying to do with my organization called India Welfare Trust. The intent is to try and understand what can we possibly do to get a lot of Indians to volunteer. The aspiration, as you can see on your screen, is to see if we can get every Indian to volunteer. That's a moonshot, it's a long dream. But that is something that we are aiming and aspiring to do at some point eventually. And that's the hope. So I'm going to share a little bit about what we've been doing there. It's not to promote our work, because we barely do any work. It's rather to promote other people's work, because that's the nature of support that we provide. I'll be talking a bit about that, but before that, just want to set a little more context in terms of what I understand volunteering really is, and how that to some extent has been redefined over the last year that I've been engaging with volunteering organizations. I am going to start sharing the slides now. My engagement or my story with volunteering actually began long back, right since I was a kid. But proper volunteering happened only when I was in college and started volunteering for a learning center in Dharavi, where I would go in the evenings and teach children anything that they want to teach, because in a room as small as the one that you find in a typical Dharavi household, there's not much space really for you to do much. So there were kids from all age groups coming and talking and asking questions. So ek jagah par main jab kisi ko biology sikha raha tha, simultaneously I was also trying to get someone's trigonometry right. That is also the kind of approach I've had to my own academics and engineering. It was a really beautiful experience in terms of understanding the communities better, understanding what kind of work do NGOs do at a much closer detail. And that sort of also has been very instrumental in allowing me to define my career trajectory the way it has shaped up. So I decided to work in the social sector primarily because of the kind of experience I've gotten in volunteering at the learning center in Dharavi and a couple of other things I did. So just want to also add a disclaimer that please do not try this at home in case you also get too inspired by volunteering and by joining the sector. Please give it a lot of thought. We can have a conversation about it later, but it can harm your career choices in a very, very significant way. So just I wanted to add a disclaimer. I wish someone had done that for me. I've also, like a typical PPT and wannabe MBA person, I have added a slide called Who is a Volunteer? I Googled up when I started working in the volunteering space. I figured that volunteering actually was coined as a noun first in the year 1600. And the definition at that point was one who offers himself for military services. As you can see in the footnotes, the source of this is not a WhatsApp forward, but it's Wikipedia. It's only in the later 1600s is when the scope of volunteering was expanded to social and civic causes. So just wanted to share this interesting trivia. And that's pretty much what I want to share, because given the current political situation, we all know what we can best volunteer for. So this is pretty much it for people who really want to get started and can just want to start volunteering ASAP. You can follow our government and look for volunteering opportunities directly with them. For people who are still confused, want to know a little more, I have a couple of more slides. The dictionary definition of volunteering or volunteer either means a person who voluntarily undertakes or expresses a willingness to undertake a service. What has been interesting is while we typically think of volunteering, and again, all of this is coming from my own personal experience of how I have evolved in my own understanding of this, is that while this is the technical definition given to us by a lot of English or Western dictionaries, I really found it very interesting to also look at the Hindi definition or the way volunteering is understood in the Indian or the local context. And to be very, very honest, over the last year, if I would say there's a major shift that has happened in my perception of how people volunteer, why do they volunteer, it's actually been somewhere between this transition of an English understanding of the word and what it means to be a volunteer and what it feels to be doing a volunteering activity to the Hindi one, or the more sort of local understanding, which is Swayamseva. And I'll touch upon this at a later point, but just the difference between the two, I think, is when we perceive that what do I do as a volunteer? I wish to volunteer. Can I look for opportunities? We often do it in the first way, which is to look for very structured institutional ways of volunteering. Whereas what happens in the latter is that it may or may not be structured, it may not be institutional also. But at the same time, the spirit with which it's done, the intent which people volunteer, is much, much deeply rooted in the cultural sort of roots that we have, in the spiritual roots to a certain extent that we have, and also a lot of other values that sort of define our society as we understand. So we can talk about this in a little more detail, but just to give you an example, the former definition could be something like a Robin Hood Army model, where people do food distribution. Amazing organization, love them, have been following them, I'm a big, big fan of what they do. But the second example, Swayamsevak example of doing food distribution would be Gurudwara. They also technically do the same thing, but the intent and the action itself is slightly different. Again, just a very basic thing that I wanted to share, how this shift has happened in my own understanding of how volunteering is perceived. The other thing I wanted to discuss is why people volunteer. I think this is again based on my understanding that people typically see certain problems in the society and they know that there are certain solutions to these problems, but we have often find ourselves at a distance from both the problems and the solutions. So one of the reasons why we want to volunteer is to come close either to the problem or to the solution, and volunteering actually is a great way of doing that. So people typically ask me that, you know, how is it that I can contribute to the society, or what is it that I can do to help? I often say that the best way to do that is to actually volunteer, not give money, give anything else, but actually volunteer so that you have a better understanding of the problem and the solution itself. And then you can choose to engage with it at whatever level it is that you wish to engage. Yeah. So after you start volunteering, and this is based on my own personal life journey and that of a volunteer, is that you start understanding or relating to the problems a little more. Your understanding of the problem also expands over time. So the way you perceive problem itself also changes completely, because from external point of view, it may look like a very different problem, something that you may not be a part of directly. But once you start engaging with volunteering as an activity, it's when you start thinking of problems in a much larger realm, and you also relate to it in a much direct manner, and you see yourself to be a part of the problems also in some cases, which is fantastic. And similarly, you also see yourself becoming a part of the solutions, right? So unlike just looking at problems and solutions, or just problems and then cribbing about it, once you start volunteering, you also become a part of the solutions, and that also keeps expanding, because there are so many solutions to a lot of problems that we have in the world. Disclaimer, Arnab Goswami joke is coming. So people, while they volunteer, they become a part of either problems or solutions, but people who watch Republic TV are still outside of both these realms. That was the only Arnab Goswami joke I had. So sorry if I've disappointed you and if it wasn't funny enough. Over the last year, what we've also been trying to do is understand volunteering better, instead of saying that we know a lot about volunteering. That's why the session is also coming from a place where I am fully sharing this, that I do not know everything about volunteering. We've been trying to understand. And one such way in which we did that was to run a survey. As you can see on your screen, we had, I think, surveyed about 2,612 people across different organizations in India, and ask them a bunch of questions as to why do you volunteer, what is your motivation. As you can see, a lot of people said, majority of people said that they want to volunteer because they want to improve things or help people, which goes back to my previous slide around wanting to be a part of a problem or a solution. Similarly, you see a lot of other reasons also that you may resonate with. Please drop in the, please let us know in the comments if there's anything that you resonate with. There are also reasons like it's part of my value system, religious beliefs, help people. One very interesting thing, the one after that, is I want to make friends, or I want to meet people. Interestingly, a lot of young male responders chose that compared to other ones, just saying. But yeah, these were very interesting sort of insights. There was a bit of a bias in the survey, again as a disclaimer, because I think 50% of the responders were from under 30 age group or demographic. So a lot of responses might be biased towards them. But this is just to give you an overview of various motivations for people to volunteer. Now, when we look at volunteering, there can be different kinds of volunteering opportunities. I typically classify them depending on the nature of opportunities, whether it's a physical opportunity that requires you to go out there and volunteer yourself, whether it's a skill-based opportunity requires you to apply a skill, whether physically, whether you need to be physically present or you can do it remotely is completely up to you. Sometimes volunteering opportunities are also defined by the nature of problem itself. There is a social problem or a civic problem. A lot of organizations which facilitate volunteering, I mentioned them in the later slides, also look at volunteering opportunities depending on the duration, whether it's a one-time opportunity or it's an ongoing one. Lastly, I also feel that when we talk about the self and how we perceive ourselves being a part of anything, like not just volunteering, I think our understanding of it is also basis who are we doing this for, right? Are we solving a problem that affects me as an individual? And there's nothing wrong with that. Or is it trying to help someone else and solve their problems, right? So typically when we are thinking about opportunities, it's good to sort of pick one of these sort of frameworks or filters and to see if you want to look at any of these as a filter to look for more volunteering opportunities. So this is again, I'm sure all these slides will be shared with you if you find it useful at all. We also found this very interesting chart. That this organization called Build the World, we've given them credits, Nitya, had come up with, where they said that when people think of opportunities, they think of literally everything, right? Like anything I can do is a volunteering opportunity, which technically it is. But if you want to look at how do you find the right opportunity, right? We can maybe refer to something like this. So if you look at the two axes, the skills and the challenges axis, when you look at an opportunity which is highly skilled, but at the same time is, if you as a volunteer are looking for a highly skilled opportunity, but the opportunity is not as challenging, then it may lead to a state of boredom where you feel that you have a lot to offer to solve a problem or to do as a volunteer. What you've been given to do as a volunteer is very thanda or very boring. Similarly, if you look at something, if the first opportunity you choose to do as a volunteer is something that is very highly challenging on the y-axis, and skills may or may not be required to do that, the challenge required or the challenge sort of it puts you on you is extremely high, and it can lead to anxiety that I don't know if I'm able to do this, or I don't know if I'm qualified to do a volunteering or to volunteer for an opportunity like this, right? So when you look at an opportunity, it's always sort of look for this sort of sweet spot in the middle to see if we can find something which maybe at the beginning just gives us a sense of basic impact, because that's a major, major motivation for people to volunteer, and it's completely right. Right? So can we look at growing from basic impact to higher impact without sort of steering towards one of the axes completely? Right? Very technical, I know, and that's why the next slide says this. In case people, you didn't understand what I meant, it's perfectly okay. I was just showing off that we have some cool stuff and we look at graphs and all that cool things as well. But yeah, this is just to give you a perception of when you're approaching a volunteering opportunity and want to think through what that is, then this might be a good filter of looking for the right opportunity. Where can you find these opportunities? I've listed a few places. There are a bunch of volunteering intermediary platforms like iVolunteer, Connect4. They have a bunch of really interesting useful volunteering opportunities as well, given the current situation around COVID. You can also look for local NGOs, civic action groups like Project Mumbai, for example, in Bombay has done phenomenal work with general sort of civic engagement, but also specifically around COVID. Similarly, there are organizations like Reap Benefit, which take a very different, much structured, but very, very cool approach to citizen engagement and citizen problem solving. You should definitely check them out. They have a very cool website and an app. Online opportunities like eVidyaloka, which allows you to teach children remotely, has been doing this successfully for the past few years. Those three projects I'm going to talk about in much detail later. I know there are a couple of people from the project here. I will be endorsing that for the money that I've received from them through check. The other way I think people often don't look at volunteering is on social media, and I'm going to place a statistic around it. I just wanted to share that for me also, Facebook, a lot of opportunities on Twitter have been a great source to discover opportunities to volunteer. A couple other areas where people often don't look for opportunities are faith-based or religious organizations. As I said, local gurudwaras are a great place if you ever want to start volunteering without really complicating with any of the things that I've mentioned so far. Just go and offer your help, and I'm sure they'll be more than happy to take your help. And similarly, any other faith-based or religious organizations, for two reasons. One, I think their motivation to do what they're doing is extremely intense. And secondly, the scale at which they do it is absolutely mind-boggling. So the largest volunteering organizations in the entire are actually the faith-based and religious ones and not your NGOs, right? And lastly, I think one sort of underserved community when we think of volunteering is the local ward and government office. So people often say that, okay, I'll work for an NGO because they're trying to do good for the society, but what we often forget is that the government is also trying to do good, right? At the local level, state level, national level. And it's often that they also require a lot of help. And we've seen a lot of instances where people have gone to a police station or gone to a fire brigade and just offered their help, saying that, can we do something to help you? And it's been phenomenal. I'll talk about a couple of case studies in the later slides. But it's a great, great idea if you want to ever reach out to, just reach out to your local ward office or any government, even if it's an MLA, MP, regardless of whether you align with them politically or not, or someone in the opposition, just reach out to them and offer to volunteer, and you'll be surprised at the kind of opportunity that you'll get. Non-political ones also. Again, referring to the survey, we had done a lot of people had responded to where did they find these opportunities, just sharing some numbers around that. As you can see, 717 out of 2,600 odd people said they found it from an organization. 697, almost 700 people also said that they discovered an opportunity through a friend. So this gives you two reasons to volunteer. One is so that you can do volunteering yourself, but also share it with other people so that they start volunteering. Then the third largest reason was, the largest source was social media. And the fourth one, I think, was searched on the internet. People are still discovering opportunities there. So if you're looking for opportunities and these are your mediums, you are on the right track. We also asked people what will allow you to volunteer more, right? If you're already doing 2 hours in a week or maybe once a month or once a year, what will allow you to do a lot more? The top three reasons, as you can see, are people saying that if the timing when I have to volunteer, if that can be flexible, I would love to do more. If the volunteering location is very close to where I live, I would love to do more. And if it's also aligned with the cause area that I'm passionate about, I would love to do more. So typically, again, when you're thinking of opportunities, don't want this to be a lot of technical stuff for you. But just wanted to share that these are some of the filters that people use when looking for a volunteering opportunity. So instead of looking for volunteering opportunities very randomly, you could apply some of these filters to discover them. I was also said that I am supposed to say some inspirational things through the medium of this talk. I promise I won't take more than 5 more minutes and then I'll shut up and leave it up to you for questions and everything else. I have 3 inspirations or stories to share. As you may recognize, the person in this picture is me, the one on the left, just clarifying. That's me from a mentoring program. I used to mentor this kid from a school in Bombay for a couple of years. Again, a very, very life transforming journey. And one of the best things that I've learned about that I want to share with all of y'all is that when I mentored him, as you can see, he's clearly not very mentored or inspired from me in the picture. He's focused on the football match happening in front of us. But the major sort of takeaway for me was that when we often look at volunteering, we only look at giving, or we think of ourselves as a person who is the giver and has a lot more to offer and receive ourselves. Right? And my mentee actually taught me much, much more than what I had to offer or what I had to teach him over the course of those 2 years that I mentored him. I just wanted to share that when you're looking at volunteering, don't just look at it as an opportunity for you to give or give back or one of those kind of inspirations. Also look at it from a place of wanting to learn something new, wanting to acknowledge that you are privileged, which is a great thing, and a bunch of other things. So just be open to the idea or the possibility of this being two ways and not one way. And similarly, as I said, the Dosti project, as I mentioned here, is a bunch of really, really interesting people, volunteers, entire group of volunteers. I think 3-4 of them are here on this Zoom call today, have come together and have started putting a mentoring program from scratch, which is entirely volunteer run. In fact, they're currently recruiting for volunteers in Cuff Parade and in Powai in Bombay. So if you're looking to work with a child to mentor them and are willing to give a couple of hours in a week, Riddhi, Ria, if any one of you can drop a link to your application or to your website or to anything else in the comments, that'll be really helpful. Do check it out. I love them for 2 reasons. One is because they're doing this. I'm sure they'll do a much better job at mentoring than I ever could. And secondly, because it's an entirely volunteer-led initiative. There's no full-time person working on this. The other thing that I wanted to share is this 500 points to whoever is able to connect these two dots, which is Ville Parle and Pigeons. And I will give that 500 points to myself because I don't think anybody here will have any context of what I'm talking about. But just wanted to share an experiment. So in our effort at India Welfare Trust, we've been working on promoting volunteering or anybody volunteering to through two ways. One is to support existing volunteering programs or initiatives, and the other is to also build some experiments to scale volunteering in India. And one of those ideas is to create a more hyper-local model of volunteering, where we are saying that if you are able to create more social and civic volunteering opportunities which are much closer to where a person lives, then the likelihood of them volunteering is much, much, much higher. Right, because that then solves for a lot of other factors. If you're keeping the location as constant, then your cause area can be taken care of, your time convenience can be taken on, and all the other factors that I mentioned will be taken into consideration. So this example that I have in front of me is actually quite fascinating, because we started this idea of this hyperlocal volunteering model in Bilepalli. It got stopped because of COVID and everything else that followed. But what was fascinating for me was when I Googled Bilepalli volunteering opportunities or Bilepalli NGOs, I got maybe like 4 or 5 responses, out of which 2 were dysfunctional. But when I started walking around the streets and started asking very random set of people, I tapriwala guy ki yahan par bhi volunteer karta hai kya? Then ha, yahan pe ek youth group aata hai jo har 6 mahine mein blood donation camp setup karta hai. We discovered there was a local citizens group which was doing traffic management every single day on a purely voluntary basis. It's nowhere on Facebook, it's nowhere on social media, or on website, or on the net. But there's still a set of 50-60 people doing that. There's a group of 80 people doing solid waste management only in Bilepalli, from building, from collecting waste from different buildings, segregating it, and then also sending it for recycling and doing all the awareness work and stuff. And similarly, brings me to the slide in the picture, we also discovered a group of people who are trying to solve the prison problem in Bilepalli. This is a very interesting problem. There is a temple in Bilepalli East, very close to where my office is, where people typically feed the pigeons. They buy some jowar or bajri and then they feed the people there, the pigeons there. And while it has a religious connotation to it, there are other citizens in that area who are bothered by the pigeons because of their overpopulation, their tendency to just shit everywhere, wherever they are. So there is a group sort of promoting feeding of pigeons, there's also a very active citizen group somewhere in Bilepalli East, which is trying to actively advocate against feeding pigeons in that area. So they're not saying you shouldn't feed pigeons, but don't do it here because it affects us directly. But the larger point that I'm trying to make from all of this is that while we think there are a lot of opportunities in these structured ways in a lot of these places, there are so many hundreds and thousands possible opportunities happening around you that you may not even know about. Right? So I actually, by the end of the exercise of listing opportunities in Bilepalli, had a list of almost 150 opportunities, out of which I didn't know more than 140. Right? So it's fascinating, once you step out and start looking for opportunities, how much can you discover happening around you and how people are trying to solve either a social problem or a civic problem that affects you or affects others in your vicinity. So just wanted to share that also. And lastly, just also setting an intention or expectation in Blue Ribbon Speak. I think it's been very inspiring to see a lot of organizations, volunteers do incredible work during COVID, whether it's food distribution, whether it's helping medical staff, helping a bunch of people, including the police, etc. I also am very, very positive and optimistic about what the post-COVID world looks like. I'm very hopeful that people don't stop volunteering only because things have started opening up, or if they feel that now that I've done enough, maybe, and stuff like that. And this is maybe something that we can talk about in greater detail after I have set up. But yeah, I think one of the larger shifts that I see happening is this idea of hyperlocal, where people will start looking for things to do more in their vicinity, in their area where they reside or where they work. Second, I think the way they perceive volunteering will move from just an NGO-based model of volunteering to a more problem-solving approach of volunteering, where you look for or seek problems in your vicinity and try and solve them. And yeah, I think just also look at broadening the type of volunteering opportunity as not just something social or civic, but also something that we engage with on a more direct basis. What next? I think as a next step, my suggestion to the group or to myself to begin with is to seek and solve local opportunities before we want to do anything big. Start with small, copy-paste error. This is what happens when you do last minute prep as taught by engineering. I wanted to write, start with small, start with self. So I should do that and start with small and start with self. I'm not making such kind of errors. So what I mean is, do not look for great opportunities. You might find something which is much large scale and all of that, and that's great, but rather look at something that you can start at an individual level, household level, even if something as basic as starting waste segregation at your household level, at a building level, etc. And then start with yourself and see how you are engaging with the problem as well as the solution, and how your evolution as a volunteer comes along. The last S doesn't really mean anything. I just know that it's typically good to have like alliteration kind of patterns and odd numbered. So SSS, like three S's of volunteering or something. So I just added S for the sake. Sorry, whoever is offended and has turned on their mic.
Person just mute their mics. Okay. Yeah.
Cool. Lastly, from my end, if you have any questions, ideas around volunteering, things that you want to share, cool articles or good morning forwards, you can share them to me, share them with me at NGOWala on all social media except Snapchat and TikTok, obviously. And or you can email me at dharmaraj@iwk.com. And if you prefer the old school way, pigeons, as we know, are our dear friends. Feel free to send any questions, ideas or messages to the pigeons as well. Suchna Samap, thank you so much for listening. This is all I had to share. Any questions, any galis on how... Oh, by the way, I'm very, very sorry. I wanted to give a disclaimer at the very outset that I was chosen to do this session after they were rejected by two people. So the Blue Ribbon team... The Blue Ribbon team, and it's true story, Blue Ribbon team had approached two people before me to host this session around volunteering. Both of them said no. And they're like, now who do we choose? And I am the third person. So I know this was supposed to be said at the outset as a disclaimer, that set your expectations at the third level, not at the first level. But I'm sure by now you're convinced that it's not even third, it's actually much below that. But yeah, I have it as a note here. So just wanted to share that you are talking to someone who's a rejected chosen person. So sorry about that.
Yeah, you're talking to the third person.
I'm talking to the third person in first person. Yes. Awesome. I will take this liberty of asking people to raise hands, unmute. I haven't been checking chats, so I'll do that now. Meanwhile, Arvind, if you've discovered any questions, feel free to.
Yeah. So one thing we could do is, of course, chats me, you can definitely type it out. But if you're going to speak, then my request is if you could raise your hands, because then while Dharmaraj is a multitasker, I'm not. So it'll be a little tough for me to handle that as well. So if you want to speak and raise any questions or share something, then please do raise your hands. Chat mein to aap kari sakte ho. So yeah, the chat is completely fine. And Vile Parle mein bahut sare pigeons hain, that's where he works. So pigeons are also a definite option. So yeah.
I just have one more pun. You were sort of pigeonholed into this conversation, everyone.
Yeah.
Thank you for that, Dharmaraj. Also requesting those who can, also to turn on their video camera so that Dharmaraj knows who he is talking to.
Yes. And whoever has put on a face mask on a Sunday morning, I can see you.
And at some point, we can also hope to take a nice picture with all the people who are present here.
That's just proof. Hum photo leke rakhenge.
Ha.
Dharmaraj ke liye, so that he'll frame it and he can tell people, kare dekho, ye sab sachi mein aaye the karke. So, yeah.
Yeah. Also, I just read a comment by someone saying, "Dheere bol bhai." So, in case kuch maine fast bol diya and suna nahi, I don't think itna kuch valuable maine waise bhi bola hai. But if you feel that there's anything that was missed because I was running to catch a local train wale speed mein main baat kar raha tha, so please ask. I can go back to slides. I can answer any other questions related to any stuff that I've said. Shuru kare leke kabutar ka naam. Any questions? Oops. अच्छा चैट पे क्या है
चलो किसी ने तो बोल दिया ओके
इफ यू डोंट हैव क्वेश्चन दैट्स आल्सो परफेक्टली फाइन
आई थिंक आकांक्षा हैज अ क्वेश्चन
आकांक्षा यस आकांक्षा आई नो आवर पॉडकास्ट इज ड्यू फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम
आई नो आई
टू पब्लिकली कॉल मी आउट ऑन दैट
नो आई कैन टेक दिस लाइक एज अ प्रीकर्सर पायलट है अभी ये had a question with regards to volunteering. Like, I am looking at this pool of people who are not in the social impact space right now, okay? And it is changing, but I feel a lot of people still have the mindset that we will start volunteering after a certain age. right? Yeah. We will make, like, right now I'm volunteering for myself. Matlab mujhe khud ka life, you know, I have to take it till a certain point. And yeah. then I will start giving back to the society. I know it's changing, but it would be interesting to kind of know from this group if you have kind of come across such friends. How do you approach that kind of school of thought, right? Because I don't think, again, there is any right or wrong to it. But when we are trying to, like, get every Indian to volunteer, why waste that time in my head? So that's where I was coming from.
Thanks. Also, one sort of sharing is that if anybody else feels they have a better answer, which I'm sure 9 out of 10 times you would, feel free to also answer anybody else's questions, respond to it with another question, anything that you feel. It's going to be a little more fluid and free flowing from now. So I do not hold all the answers to life, that we all know what it is. But I will try and respond to Akanksha's question. I think my larger learning has been that if people are given a choice, they would want to volunteer. They may not think about what life stage they are in unless they are made to think like that. I think most people, when approached with a request to help, and if they're available at that point in time, they will respond and they will help. Right? So I think who you are asking in terms of at what life stage they are in is also a function of what are you asking them to do. Right? So if, for example, if you ask someone to volunteer every single day for a few hours, that may not be possible for someone who has a daily job which requires them to put in X number of hours or whatever. But if you ask, say, a different demographic, if you ask homemakers, for example, and there are some really good examples. You should definitely check out an organization called Angel Express Foundation. They do phenomenal work around teaching children across Mumbai. And all of their volunteers, like I think 80-85% of their volunteers are homemakers across the city. They're the ones who run the entire center. They do this on a daily basis. And I think what they've done beautifully is that they've found their target audience really well. So if you're looking at approaching people to volunteer for you, it's very important to not look at everybody as a potential volunteer, but to rather sort of strategically choose who will be your target audience, who fits into your time commitment levels, people who might be more passionate about, who are likely to be more passionate about the cause that you're trying to endorse through a volunteering effort, and also who are likely to sort of be seeking those kind of opportunities, right? So if you're thinking like a volunteer and are also focusing on that, I think you may be able to find convert a lot of people into potential volunteers, even if they're not considering themselves to be a volunteer at some point. So it's about positioning the opportunity, I think, more than anything else. But apart from that, I think everybody, I know people who said, I want to volunteer, but can we talk in 2 months? Not today, but they will get back to you in 2 months and then they'll ask or reach out for an opportunity. So I think everybody at some level wants to do this. Does that answer your question, Akanksha?
Yeah, it was just a thought. So thank you.
Awesome. Ashok sir has put in a reminder, 30 minutes to go.
FYI. Yeah, 30 minutes to go. So we still have enough time if any of you wants to raise any questions, share something, or just in general, ask Dharmaraj how he is doing in life.
I wanted to ask one thing, so you are saying that eventually sabhi log kabhi na kabhi koi point pe they volunteer for themselves or for community or for something. I just wanted to know ki yaar aisa scene hai to jitna aapne kiya hai स्कूल में अगर उतना 15 मिनट या आधा घंटे में यही सेम प्रेजेंटेशन आप दे दोगे तो एटलीस्ट बच्चों को तो समझ में तो आएगा लाइक यू नो लाइक इफ इट इज दैट इम्पोर्टेंट सो व्हाई डू अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल डोंट कम फॉरवर्ड टू यू नो वॉलंटियर दिस इज व्हाट आई हैव ऑब्जर्व क्योंकि काफी कम लोग है जो कॉलेजेस में लाइक कॉलेजेस में हो या स्कूल में हो अगर इफ इट इज अ फन एक्टिविटी अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल वुड कम फॉरवर्ड कि एनुअल डे हुआ तो डांस करना है सिंगिंग करना है वैसे सब बट इफ दे वुड वांट समवन फॉर यू नो फॉर अ कॉज बी इट अ सोशल कॉज और एनी कॉज लाइक एनी गुड कॉज तो पीपल आई डोंट नो तो थोड़े से उन लोग वो डर जाते आई डोंट नो आई जस्ट वांटेड टू नो कि व्हाई डज दैट हैपन लाइक Is it because they just lack interest in doing that or like, you know, like according to your experience, ki aapke experience mein aapne kya dekha aise ki वो लोग आगे आने से थोड़े यू नो लाइक दे हेजिटेट लाइक व्हाई डू दे डू इट लाइक
हां आई डोंट नो इफ आई हैव अ कंप्लीट और अ राइट आंसर टू दिस बट आई थिंक इट्स अ लार्जली अ फंक्शन ऑफ द कल्चर ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और व्हाटएवर इंस्टीट्यूशन यू कम फ्रॉम इंस्टीट्यूशन कुड आल्सो मीन schools, educational institutions, colleges, etc. Or it could also mean institutions like families, right? Like, is volunteering something that's encouraged in your family, or is some practiced as a part of your friends group, right? So, for example, for me, volunteering has been an integral part of my life, not because my school told me that I should volunteer, but because my parents felt that it was important for me to start doing something at an early age. Right? So, I think it's largely a function of the culture of where we come from. And what it promotes. So if you'll also look at corporates, for example, corporate volunteering is massive and some of them do a great job at it, but it's not because their employees are better than other company employees, right? But because the company promotes volunteering at a much deeper level. It's not a once a year, jao jaakar jhaad lagao tree plantation activity. Like ek jhaad lagao. By the way, a fun story on that. There is a corporate in Tamil Nadu, true story, last year, Chennai mein, unko tree plantation karna tha. Due to some logistical issues, they found only one tree. And 60 employees, and so all the 60 employees posed with the same tree from different angles. So, I mean, that's a true story on a lighter note. But my point is that there are companies which also do deeper level of volunteer engagement. I know a lot of corporates in India which are promoting immense kind of volunteering in terms of scale, in terms of the depth of volunteering. It's not limited to one-time volunteering efforts, but people. Who are encouraged to sustain volunteering over the years. I met someone recently who's been volunteering through his company, through an IT company for more than 10 years now. Right? And this is like serious intense stuff. And he's now like a volunteer leader within the organization. He manages 200 plus volunteers within their company. Right? So the short answer to your question is that it's a function of culture. And if you are able to promote it through whatever it is that we are doing, great, you should try and do that. But I think more than anything else, my larger realization is that people do when you do. Right? So instead of saying कि अच्छा आपके स्कूल में volunteering क्यों नहीं कर रहे हैं क्या आप स्कूल में जाके पूछ सकते हो कि क्या मैं बच्चों को volunteer करा सकता हूँ right so people will always follow what you do so the action is more important than the preaching right so if I go and give a presentation on volunteering वो एक बार सब कर लेंगे बच्चे but if the school doesn't really promote that in the true spirit then it will never materialize and there are some really good by the way you should check out this school in Ahmedabad called Riverside School they do some really really good work around action-based learning. I discovered a bunch of very fascinating volunteering opportunities that they make their students undergo throughout the ages, including jab wo primary school mein hota hai, they are made to clean toilets in their own schools, right? So rather than aap kaho ki Swachh Bharat hum bahar jaake karenge, can we start by cleaning our school toilets, right? And that's a great way of sensitizing people. That's a great way of getting students to be less awkward or be more confident about just thinking of problems is not something that somebody else needs to solve and I have to just step out and do something, but can we begin by cleaning our own toilets, quite literally, right? So that's a great example. You should definitely check out. It's called Riverside School in Ahmedabad. They do a bunch of very, very fascinating things, including how they engage their students in volunteering. So there are a lot of these case studies. It's only about discovering them and seeing if we can apply it anywhere.
Okay. I have a question.
I think Riddhi, is that you?
Yeah. I can't find my video. My bandwidth is really low, but I typed in the question.
So do you want to read it out or should I read out the question?
Yeah, sure. Sure, I can read it out. So my question is very simple. There are, like, in my experience, I've seen that there are largely two kinds of volunteers, right? The kind that do something for validation, recognition, certificates, etc. Nothing wrong with that. And there are those who work with no strings attached, like in a very uninhibited, open manner. And my question for Dharmaraj is that in his experience, has he seen any difference in terms of impact and ability to connect in either of the two approaches? And can that be one more insight that some of us can get from you? Thank you.
So it's a good question. And that's how you answer all questions that you don't know answers to by saying it's a good question. No, I think we don't have sort of statistics around it. So I can't say for sure that that's the theory or that's how things work. But my understanding more from my own experiences of how some of these things work is that in terms of how it affects the impact, I don't think there's much difference. I think people's motivation to volunteer could be very different. People's reasons to do what they do could be very, very diverse and different. But having said that, I think matching that with your expectations from them is most important, right? So if you know that there are a set of people who are only doing this for a certificate and they'll be honest about it, I think there's nothing wrong with it. We should definitely engage them as well and make the most out of it. Make sure that they're learning as much from it as possible. And if we know that there are people who are doing it with no strings attached, only for the pure joy of serving or doing of volunteering, then we should try and engage them differently. So I think more than the difference in the impact, what we should consider when we are engaging with these two set of volunteers is to A, gauge which one of these do they belong to, if they can be categorized that way. Sometimes it could be a mix of both as well, somewhere in the middle. But if you have a clear categorization of who is doing this for a validation or certificate and who is doing it for a very selfless way, I think we should not choose between the two. We should engage both kinds of volunteers, but in probably different ways. And let that intention be known. That, for example, if I'm working with someone who is doing this for a very, very selfless reason, I may engage with that or engage with that person at a different level, right? Like I will probably talk to the person a lot more than I would the person who's only doing it with a very limited expectations. I have to clock 4 hours in a week versus someone who's saying 4 hours, so I will give. But beyond if it requires me to give 10 hours, I don't know if I can commit to it, but I will push and get it done, right? So once you know which one do they belong to, then your level of engagement should align accordingly. But in terms of impact, I think it's I have seen a lot of people who do things with the intention of an incentive and have really delivered quite well. So I wouldn't like bad label them saying ki acha certificate ke liye kar rahe hain to inko to chota chota kaam hi do aur jo selfless kar rahe hain unko ye do. I think people deliver. I think we should be holding them accountable to A, what they're setting the expectation or intention to be, and then try and see if we can define roles for them accordingly. But impact, I think, same here for most cases. Yeah, unless the role expects people to be to belong to one of the categories. It says that we need people who are very altruistic in nature and are not motivated by incentives, then we don't look at the people in the former category. But if it's like anybody who can only commit to this much time and do this and will promise or make sure that wo ek saal ke liye karenge, which is probably your a good example in Dosti Projects case, then I don't think we should differentiate between the two. Does that answer your question, Riddhi?
Yes, thank you.
Please send 200 rupees on my Paytm.
No, that's sorry, no China. Any Indian company, any Indian company that is willing to do that, please do try it out.
I accept bitcoins also, just letting you know, everyone. Any other questions? I think we have about 20 minutes. I again like don't want to limit it to questions. If you have questions, great. Otherwise, you can also open it up for other people to share what they've been doing, what they've done as volunteers, any interesting experiences, any bad experiences also that you think needs to be fixed by people who work in the volunteering sector. Anything remotely related to volunteering or pigeons is completely welcome. Please, guys and girls. And Arvind.
That really puts things into a different perspective. When you say guys, girls, and Arvind. But okay. So observations. Anybody else wants to share something? So yeah, the floor is open. Or if you want to grill Dharmaraj even more, then he's up for that too. He's up to be grilled like a fine barbecue. So Ritesh ji, aap kafi der se bahut shant lag rahe ho aap. Nitish,
sir,
yes, काफी दूर चले गए हमसे.
All good, sir, all good, and as usual, love Dharmaraj's antics and his jokes. Love you too, sir, and yeah, but like fantastic presentation, considering that you just built that. You just made that presentation in the time when these guys were facilitating and opening the breakout rooms. But I and the slide about the slide from WhatsApp forward, but from the build the world was pretty interesting. How can we keep a center between the skills and the challenges.
Yeah.
So in fact, just related to that, and also the kind of work that you guys at IWT and the model that Reap Benefit has built, the volunteer framework. So for example, like how Reap Benefit takes workers from say from the baseline to champion volunteers to make them problem solvers instead of just focusing on the issues or problems. And for example, the fantastic program that you built, the 10-week program around that took from empathy, exposure to understanding, and then evangelization. So what are the other kind of models that that, you know, like new organizations, new volunteering organizations can take up, like apart from these, that focus more on like social and civic issues that you might have come up, or maybe you can also expand on the model of Reap Benefit and IWT that you guys built.
I'm gonna look up. I think I should have slides for both, but I don't have an answer to that. I haven't discovered a new framework. I think the major challenge, and brings me back to the first point that I made around Western definition and our perception or engagement with that kind of volunteering versus a more local or Indian one, I think is that a lot of the work that happens in terms of very organic volunteer engagement in faith-based organizations, religious organizations, or any other organizations also, is not very well documented. So how they scale opportunity, like for example, if you think about it, like the number of people who engage or volunteer with a Gurudwara, or even I forget whether it's Isha Foundation or Art of Living or one of these, you're talking to them to understand how they engage volunteers. And I think one of them said that at any given point in time, they have at least 7.5 lakh volunteers across the country, across all their centers, because most of their work is done by volunteers. Right? And if we ask them that what is their motivation to volunteer, they're, like, they're just giving back because of all that they've gained from the institution. Right? But there is a great opportunity for us to learn from some of these models on how they are building such massive scaled volunteering opportunities or operations based on very common drivers or based on the opportunity that you create for people to give back, right? So I think some of these have a lot of potential to study. We haven't studied any of them, but it'll be nice to explore, keep exploring. Our journey at IWT with every Indian volunteering has been to not just say that we know everything. I think every single day has been a huge learning curve in terms of how we change our understanding of how some of these things work around volunteering. So it's a constant work in progress, sir. I will see if I have the Reap Benefit and the IWT side. Meanwhile, any other questions, please welcome. We have also 15 minutes. Huh.
Also inviting those who have not spoken at all, if they have anything to share, how did they feel about the session? Even if they don't have questions, they want to share anything else.
And there is just a disclaimer, there is no beep feature on Zoom. So if you want to use any of those words, kindly send them to me on chat, unless you want to be publicly known for the person who called me out. Using the right set of words, I think the intention and the words will be very correct. I also say those things to myself every once in a while.
We are recording it too. So we can send it to Dharmaraj so that he is constantly reminded of that. But yeah.
Also, this recording will go on social media. So yeah.
Oh, yes.
So yeah, we are threatening you from all sides, Dharmaraj.
Just send him pigeons. Pigeons, like how he said it.
Baki log, question. By the way, sorry, Angel Express, when I bula, we have Askar on this chat who works with Angel Express. So if you want to know more about them, about any of their programs, you can write to Askar. He's on the group. People who are interested in the Gusti project can reach out to Riddhi, to Musamil, to Ria, and to one more person, right?
Manohar has raised his hand.
Oh my God!
Wow!
Manohar, sir!
Kaun aa gaya hai, dekho.
You don't do this.
yeah, Manohar, sir, please. It's an honor.
So, मेरा एक जेन्युइन सवाल है जो मैं काफी दिन से कम से पूछना चाहता था. उसका मौका नहीं मिला. एक ये कि दो तरह के लोग पे बात हुई अभी कि एक लोग जो जॉय ऑफ वॉलंटियरिंग के लिए काम करता है, फिर दूसरे इंसेंटिव्स के लिए काम करता है. एक और बिरादरी से मेरी मुलाकात हुई है जिनमें से एक ने मुझे एक बार एक आर्टिकल भेजा था वॉलंटियर्स फॉली करके, और उसका पॉइंट ये था कि वॉलंटियरिंग करने से बेहतर मैं अगर पैसे डोनेट कर दूं तो वो उसकी लाइफ में ज्यादा इम्पैक्ट डालेगा। अब इनके साथ प्रॉब्लम ये है कि इनका फोकस इम्पैक्ट है, तो इनको जवाब दिया कि जॉय ऑफ वॉलंटियरिंग या डीपर कल्चरल वाली बात, तो वो बोलते हैं नहीं हमारा फोकस तो इम्पैक्ट है। तो अगर तुम बता सकते हो कि वॉलंटियरिंग से ज्यादा इम्पैक्ट कैसे आएगा वर्सेस पैसे देने से, तो मैं वॉलंटियरिंग के लिए भी तैयार हूँ। तो मैं वहां पे वो रिस्पॉन्स में डगमगा जाता हूँ। तो आई वुड लव टू नो अगर तुमने इस पे कुछ सोचा।
सॉरी आई वाज जस्ट लुकिंग फॉर द रीप बेनिफिट वाला स्लाइड, आई विल पुट इट अप सून। बट आई थिंक द देयर इज अ स्टडी बीइंग डन बाय सम डोनेशन प्लेटफॉर्म, आई थिंक इट्स चैरिटीज एड फाउंडेशन, कैफ इंडिया या कैफ इंटरनेशनल ने स्टडी किया है, यू शुड चेक इट आउट। आई थिंक इट्स एन इंटरनेशनल स्टडी ऑन डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ गिविंग एंड हाउ पीपल फेल्ट अबाउट द काइंड ऑफ इम्पैक्ट दैट द गिविंग क्रिएटेड। But if I remember currently, there was a very interesting statistic, and there are two agencies ke jiske report I'll check, and Manohar, I'll share them with you separately, and anybody else who's also interested, let me know. So I think there were two very interesting surveys, one done by Charities Aid Foundation, and the other one was by this agency called NCVO in the UK, which is a massive UK-based volunteering agency. Both of them, I think, had said that in case people donate, then there is a certain X amount of impact, and then if they volunteer, it's a completely different thing. But if people choose to do the other way around, where they donate, when they volunteer first and donate later, the likelihood of them donating more is much higher. Like it's significantly higher, as much as I think 60% is ज़्यादा था. So अगर कोई सीधा volunteer सीधा donation करता है, तो वो जो X amount देंगे, versus somebody who volunteers and then gives money. Because then you understand, going to back to my initial slide around when you start volunteering, you come closer to the problem and to the solution, and then are able to even perceive the problem or the solution in a much more intimate and a different way. Then the likelihood of you wanting to donate also and how much you will donate is much, much higher. Because then you know, achha, agar mujhe food or hunger is an issue that I discover through my volunteering with Robin Hood or any such organizations, then instead of just paying for 10 meals in a year, I will A, volunteer and then figure out kya aur bhi problems hai ki kitna zyada nutrition is a huge issue. So when we talk about food and hunger, we never look at nutrition as a part of the same problem, right? But when you start volunteering, you'll know ki acha, haan, food matlab sirf khichdi khilana nahi hai. There's also a lot of other things or other nutritional things that people from low income communities need. So your engagement in the form of giving changes drastically once you approach it first as a volunteer and then as a donor, right? But it's what people should choose. I think it's completely a function of what stage they are in, what are they more comfortable giving. But what I have learned is that if people volunteer, even if they just volunteer and do not give, still their engagement with the problem and their ability to then work on it is much, much, much higher. Like, I'll give you one quick example. So I know a person who volunteers with the Robin Hood Army, and she's been doing it for a while. She also discovered how nutrition is a huge issue. And instead of doing something really big or massive, what she started doing was anybody that she engages with, whether it's her house help, the office mein jaake jo staff hai, jinke paas hai utna nutritional access nahi hoga nutritional food ke liye, she started buying food packets with like nutrition for them. She's like, acha, I understand that people if they belong to a certain sort of income group, they may not have access to these things. So she started giving out those protein bars or whatever, those other things, because she recognized that that's also a problem that needs to be solved. Right, so it really changes your perception and how you're able to address or engage with the problem at a much, much personal level while thinking of it in a more larger realm. Yeah, does that answer your question, sir?
Yes, thank you so much. It's useful.
Akashwani, जैसे बीच-बीच में अशोक का मैसेज आ रहा है.
अशोक वानी, please come in.
10 minutes to go, 5 minutes to go. One thing we could do is a lot of people haven't spoken, so we could take a minute or 30 seconds or something, and then we take a pause, and then if somebody wants to pose something new or ask or share
or pose yourself in the picture in like
for anything, the field is completely yours, so we can take a 30 second pause zara tab tak aap you can gather your thoughts and maybe share.
हेलो
यस
सोहम या तो हाय आई एम सोहम फ्रॉम औरंगाबाद एंड आई हैव बीन वॉलंटियरिंग विद द पुलिस डिपार्टमेंट फॉर द लास्ट 2 इयर्स So I just saw a point in your slide. So I wanted to ask you one thing. In case of volunteering in India, there is not a much of big balance between how much to volunteer and how much to be paid for.
Sure.
So what do you think? What must be the balance of an average Indian youth to maintain a balance between volunteering, is it not taking any money for the services that you provide? And when be the balance?
Soham, tumhara last ka statement thoda voice crack ho raha tha. Can you repeat that again? Soham?
Yeah, so my question is, what should be the balance between kitna tum volunteer karoge aur kitna tum paise leke koi employment karoge? Because I have seen people who have done volunteering for the whole of their life, and eventually at the later stages of the life, they are being constantly tortured by their family ki yahi kaam isne itna itna kiya and then he has achieved a bit of success and now he is not feeling that much failures at a later part of his life. So what do you think must be a balance between ki kitna percent aap volunteer karoge aur kitna tum uske liye kuch remuneration loge?
I think it's a function of why do you want to volunteer and what are your expectations from it. I have no problem with people expecting money for their volunteering responsibilities. I don't think volunteering technically means, I mean, to some extent it does mean that you don't do it with an expectation of something in return, but if you are in a position where you're not able to or not comfortable sort of letting go of a financial incentive. If you were to, for example, abhi tum 4 ghanta kisi ke liye volunteer kar rahe ho, wo 4 ghanta shayad tum kahin aur kaam karte, so you would get certain incentive in return, right? So I think if that is the expectation that you are setting very clearly both for yourself and for the group or the organization that you are volunteering with, I think there's, I don't think there's a specific number ki acha itna aap free mein karo ya itna aap ke liye aap paisa lo, but it's largely a function of what is the outcome of your work. Right, if it's something that can be done by organizations for free, or if that's their underlying expectation, then it's wrong on our part to expect them to do anything. But if it is an organization or a group or whatever, a platform where there is a possibility for you to be paid because the kind of work that you're delivering is high quality, high outcome, very sort of, matlab uska for profit jo bhi counterpart hoga, will probably give you as much. Right. So if that is the case, then there's no harm in expecting anything in return. How much that is, I don't think there's a number to it. People typically, I was talking to Riddhi only the other day, actually, ki social sector mein jab salary mangte hain, to log, this is a similar question or a conversation in a way, I'm digressing for a bit, but people often say, jaise social sector mein ho, to kaise paise mangte ho, ya kitna paisa mangte ho, wagera, and whether you should even expect any money while working for society and stuff. I'm like, bhai, paapi pet ka sawal hai. I also need to be fed, and I need to be fed a lot because I'm a Gujarati. So I need a lot more money than an average Indian would or a human being would. I see someone commenting. I'm guessing it's one of the Gurus on the group. But my point is
that's actually Ashok.
Sorry, I know that 3 minutes or 5 minutes. Quickly, what I was discussing with Riddhi is that social sector may typically, the number that some of us think is a good number is that at least expecting 65-70% to 75% of what you would expect in a for-profit setting, right? Achha, agar aap 10,000 rupees expect kar rahe ho for the same quality of work, whatever that work may be, in a for-profit setting, can you try and see if you can get paid 6,500, 7,000 or 7,500 rupees for that? It's negotiable, but it's not zero, right? And you can also be like, achha, mera kaam 7,500 ka worth hai, but I'm choosing to take zero or I'm choosing to take whatever you offer. But the worth of my work is still tangibly measured through some of these things. It's not a verified number, so please don't go asking around for 70% of paisa and come back to me. If you do, then do it through the Kabutar medium and not through emails or on social media. But I hope that answers your question, Soham, to some extent. I'm just also sharing, I've shared a screen referring to what Nitish had just said. We had worked on an experiment to create a volunteering journey for a bunch of college students. Usme humne ye kafi kuch reap benefit yahan pe niche, I think Reddit bhi diya hai. Sorry. Somewhere there, I'll have to check. But basically, shuru mein hi hoga shayad. So this was basically created where we felt ki agar humko kisi bhi issue ke baare mein janna hai ki hum kaise engage kare. So there are 4 levels of doing it. I'll jump directly to an example so that we have a little more context. So we said ki agar aapko किसी की चीज के लिए वॉलंटियर करना है एंड दिस इज व्हाट वी हैड डन फॉर अ ग्रुप ऑफ कॉलेज स्टूडेंट्स अक्रॉस दीज फोर कॉज एरियाज. सो स्टूडेंट्स केम टू अस सेइंग कि हमको एनवायरमेंट के लिए काम करना है, पीपल विद डिसेबिलिटीज के लिए काम करना है, एनिमल्स के लिए काम करना है, एजुकेशन के लिए काम करना है. वी हैड फाइव वॉलंटियर्स ईच फॉर ईच ऑफ दीज कॉज एरियाज. सो हमने कहा कि वो करने के लिए कैन वी एक्सपेरिमेंट विद दीज फोर लेवल्स ऑफ वॉलंटियर एंगेजमेंट. जिसमें हमने कहा वन मिनट लेफ्ट व्हाट
वन मिनट या आई थिंक दैट जस्ट वो इंडियंस को थोड़ा पांच मिनट पहले बताते ना कि हो गया टाइम. आई थिंक इट्स दैट काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग.
करेक्ट करेक्ट. सो आई वोंट टेक मच टाइम. ये भी सो विल आल्सो बी शेयर्ड विद यू इफ एनीबॉडी इज इंटरेस्टेड इन नोइंग दिस. ब्रेकआउट रूम्स विल क्लोज. ओके
यस. सो आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट धर्मराज ये मे बी आप शेयर कर सकते हैं लेटर एंड यू कैन क्लोज द सेशन यू वर टॉकिंग विद एनीथिंग एंड देन इफ एनीबॉडी हैज एनीथिंग और वी कैन टर्न ऑन द कैमरास क्विकली.